Gohan, this is Sebastian with Cost of Performance. This will be your day three exercises. This is section one, your lower body hinge. So I've got two bands attached down here. This one's just a solid loop through. This other one has handles. You can do it with either exercise. So this is exercise one, which is going to be that band pull through. It's gonna be supersetted with that single arm RDL. So I'm holding onto the handles of that band. I've got it anchored nicely. I go soft in my knees, and the main premise of that hinge is hips go backward. I feel a stretch in my glutes. I keep my back flat. I squeeze my glutes, and I come up out of it. Okay, I can do that same thing again. I can do that with the handle band, or I can do it with the band with the loops. I'm holding either side of that band. It pulls my hips backwards. I squeeze, and I come up out of it. A little bit wider stance on those. The superset is going to be your single arm RDL. So I'm going to do five with it, my right hand, five with it, my left hand. We're gonna go soft in the knees, okay? A little bit closer with the feet. Hips go backward. I'm really trying to stay centered here. It's gonna wanna twist you either way, and you'll wanna do a lot of compensations, but I wanna stay as neutral as I can. So then beside you, it's that same thing. Soft in the knees, hips go backward, okay? So that's exercise one, and then the superset for exercise one. Exercise two for you for that lower body hinge is gonna be a barbell RDL. So, I've got my barbell right here. We can always add weight if needed. I kind of have that neutral grip on my barbell. I'm gonna go soft in my knees, shoulders back, abs tight, hips go back behind me, and then I squeeze my glutes as I come up out of it. Hips go back behind me, I squeeze my glutes as I come up out of it. Main thing is not to let those shoulders and that back round at all. The superset for that barbell RDL is gonna be with a medicine ball. So, I'm gonna get on my knees in that medicine ball position. From here, I'm gonna hip go backwards and rotate into it. So I keep the medicine ball hot, I rotate my hip backwards, I squeeze my glutes as I come out. And I do the same thing off the other side, rotate down into it, keep that back flat, squeeze as you come up out of it. Again, the big thing is squeezing those glutes. Exercise number three for you is gonna be a sumo deadlift. So we can either use a dumbbell, a kettlebell, any singular weight, but we're gonna think kind of open stance forehand. So if I'm hitting that open stance forehand, I've got about a 45 degree angle with my toe. I'm gonna match that with my other toe, weight's in the center of my body, knees get fired to the outside, hips go backward, I feel that really big stretch on the insides of my legs, squeeze my glutes as I come up. Same thing if I'm on the side view, hips go backward, hips go backward, I feel the stretch, squeeze as I come up out of it. The superset for those is just gonna be a glute bridge, okay? So I'm just gonna lay on my back, feet go flat on the floor, then I'm gonna press my hips to the sky, squeezing my glutes up there, squeeze. This is gonna be your section two, which is core, featuring one of the Cost of Performance coaches. This is Coach Cash Hsu. Here we go. So the first exercise that you'll have is gonna be alternating V-ups, okay? So you'll be laying on your back, laying on your back, arms go wide, legs go wide, okay? And then I'm gonna go opposite arm, opposite leg. Opposite arm, opposite leg, okay? So I'm getting my shoulders up off, big reach as I try to touch that toe. That's gonna be supersetted with a rotational side plank. So that side plank position, I'm gonna be up on my elbow, shoulders stacked on top of my elbow, and then I'm gonna rotate forearm to forearm, squeeze my glutes and come open. Rotate forearm to forearm, squeeze my glutes and come open. So those two are supersetted. Exercise number two is gonna be your Russian twist with a medicine ball. We're gonna go high to low on this one, okay? So that Russian twist is sitting with my feet up, okay? I'm gonna rotate low and then rotate high. Rotate low, rotate high. So reps for that one will be done per side. That is gonna be supersetted with a tall plank opposite. So I'm gonna be in that push-up position, opposite arm, opposite leg. You're gonna go towards the sky, good stabilization up there. Opposite arm, opposite leg, go towards the sky. Good stabilization. Exercise number three is going to be your rotational mountain climbers, supersetted with a side plank hip dip. So back into that push-up position, rotational mountain climber is knee and shin, rotate to the side, back to neutral, rotate to the side, back to neutral, and then that side plank hip dip is gonna be in that side plank position again, shoulder on top of elbow, and your hip is just simply gonna go down, touch the floor, and then pop up as high as you can. Down. All right, so this is gonna be your section three, which is just gonna be a total body flexibility. The first one that you have is gonna be a three-way rocking hamstring stretch, okay? So I'm gonna rock backward with two legs, rock forward with my right leg, reach towards my toe, back with two, forward with one, back two, and then forward with two. So all three of those is gonna be one rep. All right, exercise number two in the total body flexibility. It's gonna be a pigeon stretch with the rotation. So this is my pigeon stretch. If my right leg is forward, my right hand is gonna come forward, then my left hand is gonna thread the needle, and then I'm gonna open up towards the sky. Thread the needle, open up towards the sky. Okay, that's exercise number two. Exercise number three is gonna be with a PVC pipe. You could do this with a band, you could do this with a broom, anything a little bit sturdy overhead. From here, I'm gonna lean to my side, get that really good stretch, come up, lean to my side, get that really good stretch, come up. We're just gonna go side to side from those. Make sure that we're not rolling forward or backward too much. We still have a little bit of pressure in the core. Exercise number four is gonna be on the wall, okay? So you're gonna put fingers pointing down, about shoulder height. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rotate open and relax. Rotate open and relax. We should feel a really big stretch all through that bicep.